Good morning, everyone. That's a little better than the first one that Glenda tried before. I know that we're a little disappointed with the Leafs last night, right? So we're feeling a little bit blue, but there's no need to be, right? We got to move forward. It's baseball season. We've got some hope with the Jays, I think. So my name is Tim Magwood, and I'm a storyteller and a consultant with the Mark of a Leader. It's great to be here with the TD folks. I'm a TD customer, so I've got my mortgage with TD, I've got a line of credit with TD, and so a lot of the technology infrastructure is in your hands. So I know that I'm very secure and I'm in good shape with you. So to get things started, before we dive in, I want you to turn to your neighbor and I want you to say something nice about them. Okay? It could be a really nice striped shirt. It could be the energy they've got. I want you to turn to the partner, take 10 seconds, and say something nice. Make sure you return the favor. Saying something nice goes two ways. Return the favor to your partner. Okay, good. How did that feel? Did that feel good? It feels good, right? One of my wife's best friends, Heidi, when she gets a compliment, this is what she does. Stop, right? When somebody says something nice to you, you should just encourage it, right? Because that's important. Recognition is the fuel of a positive culture. I want to do three things with you today. I got three specific goals. One is I want to challenge you. Okay, Glenda said challenge, she used the word challenge, and I want to challenge you. I want to challenge your thinking. Frankly, I want to challenge the lens in which you look at the world. I know that's a big objective, but I want to challenge your thinking. The second thing I want to do is I want to cause you to learn. Learn. We're here to learn together, and the vehicle that I'm going to use is stories. Stories. Why stories? Because stories are sticky, stories are fun. So I'm going to cause you to learn through some amazing leadership stories, since our theme today is everyone is a leader. The third thing is I want to inspire you to change. And quite frankly, if I've challenged your thinking and you've learned a couple things through stories and I haven't inspired you to change, I've failed. So my goal by the end of the day is to have you create a leadership commitment that's very personal and very meaningful for you that you're walking out the door with that you're really committed to. So I want to inspire you to change, do one or two things differently around your own leadership. What do you think? Is that doable? Yes? Who thinks that's doable? Show of hands. Okay, good. Let's put hands together. A little energy. By the way, I'm going to be kind of Captain Fun and Captain Energy today. Is that okay? I'm going to set the tone. That's the hat I brought. Okay, for some of us, the world looks a little bit like this. Just another day at the office, right? Just another day at the office at TD. A little bit of chaos, a little bit of uncertainty, right? In times of chaos, times of uncertainty, leadership is what gives us security, it gives us direction, and it guides us. So leadership is like the glue. There's lots of perspectives on leadership that I'm going to share with you, and here's one cute one. That's leadership, right? Wouldn't that be nice if that's what leadership was? Sort of like a magnet drawing towards you. That's kind of fun, right? Let's define leader, because we're here, the theme today is everyone is a leader. And if you Google leader, there's a few definitions that come up. So I'm going to give you a few quick definitions of leader. The first one is someone who has or holds hierarchical power. Someone who holds hierarchical power. So that could be the Queen, that could be President Obama, that could be leader of an organization like the late, great Steve Jobs. Someone who holds hierarchical power. Now, the problem with that definition is it's very limiting, isn't it? Because there's only a few at the top who can actually be a leader, which goes against our definition today of everyone's a leader. But that's a definition, number one. Definition number two is someone who holds control. Someone who holds control. Policemen, right? Nurses, doctors, firefighters. Someone who has control. Now, we all have access to that definition, don't we? Someone who has control. Now, with firefighters, you know, if you're, God forbid, your house is engulfed in flames, and a firefighter walks in your door and tells you instructions, and you sit there arguing with them, only an idiot's gonna do that, right? You're gonna do what you're told, and you're gonna run out the front door. Someone who's in control. That's the second definition. The third definition is someone who goes first. Someone who goes first. So, in the space age, the first man who lands on the moon, scientific discoveries, innovation, someone who goes first. Now, who has gone first at some point in their life? Show of hands. Someone who's gone first sometime in their life. Who's gone first when they've regretted it? Some regret. Okay. Now, first, you know, this is the firstborn, someone who goes first. This is the third definition. I want to introduce you to a definition that I think is really awesome and one that is very accessible to all of us as technology leaders. Here it is. Help someone who helps others to be their best, right? Someone who helps others to be their best. So community workers, coaches. And since it's the NHL playoffs right now, and yes, my heart is broken too since the Leafs are out, I want to give you a great example of an amazing leader that we all know. And that guy is Wayne Gretzky. Wayne Gretzky, of course, is the all-time points leader. But one thing that is especially amazing about Wayne Gretzky is he had twice as many assists as he had goals, right? Twice as many assists as he had goals. So you know that if you were covering Gretzky, you were in real trouble because it wasn't just what he was going to do, but it was his ability to set up other people. In essence, Wayne Gretzky, and this is the key, one of the keys I want you to take away around leadership, Wayne Gretzky was able to elevate the game for those who we played with or those who played against him, right? He was able to elevate their game. And isn't that the essence of leadership? Somebody who can really elevate other people's games. Can we do that? Is that something we can do with our energy and with our focus and determination? Something, right? We can elevate the game. Now, how many of you are parents in the room? How many of you are parents? Okay, how many of you have nieces or nephews? Okay, so I think that's probably everybody. One of the most important leadership roles is a parent, isn't it? Or is an aunt or uncle showing the way or paving the way? Aren't parents those who help others to be their best, right? Helping others to be their best. But isn't it amazing that there's no guidebook or there's no manual, is there, when we become a parent, we become an uncle? Wouldn't that be nice? All we know is that when we take that baby home, we want to make sure that we create the next Oprah versus the next Charles Manson, right? It's a tough gig being a parent. Okay, so helping others to be their best. How's that as a definition? Is that something we can kind of land on together? All right, so how do we do that? How do we do that? Well, at Mark of a Leader, we've got a really simple model, because I think simple is important, called five-level leadership. So what this says is that if we as leaders engage these five levels, anything can happen, right? So five levels. What are these five levels? First of all, there's the spirit. There's the spirit. Now, this isn't just religion, but this is beyond ourselves, right? This is legacy, this is service, spirit. Then there's the imagination, which is right brain. Right brain, imagination, creativity. Then there's the intellect, which is the left brain, right? Intellect, third level. The fourth level, one of the most difficult, is the heart, engaging people's hearts. And finally, we've got the hands. So again, those fives are, we've got the spirit, right? We've got the imagination, creative. We've got the intellect. We've got heart, and we've got hands. So leadership, helping others to be their best, and aiming to engage all those levels. Question for you. In business today, which are the two predominant? Just shout out what you think are the two predominant in business today. Intellect, heart, other guesses? Imagination. Okay, so what we find in business today, the two predominant, head, hands. here's the plan for this technology project. Here are the people. Go execute it. Does that happen? Head, hands. What we miss is spirit. What's the big idea here? How can we help TD win the J.D. Power Award for what, the seventh year in a row? Is it six or seven? We've already won seven, so it'll be the eighth year in a row. How do we help? How do we help TD be more one bank? How do we help TD expand in the U.S., which is really important? Spirit, right? How do we help be more creative in terms of how we do things? How do we engage the heart, which is the why and the what's in it for me, right? Those are the things that we need to be thinking about as leaders, not just head and hands, but spirit, imagination, and heart. What do you think? Is that something we can think about doing? All right, that's a bit of theory. That's all the theory I'm going to give you today. From here on in, I'm going to tell you some stories, and we're going to have some fun.